Hi, I'm Paul Berry. Welcome to Mediabytes. And quick, run for cover.
Exposed. A bombshell is set to go off.
And did it go off? You bet.
We've obtained secret audio and video recordings that catch out the real Adam Somurek.
A faceless Labour power broker caught red-handed in industrial-scale branch stacking and his foul mouth there for all to hear.
They're dumb, they're stupid, all these little fuckers. They don't know how fucked they are.
Nor did Adam know how fucked he was.
Victorian Labour MP Adam Somurek has been sacked as minister.
One down.
And in breaking news tonight, Assistant Treasurer Robin Scott has quit state cabinet.
Two down.
Marlene Kairouz, the Minister for Gaming and Liquor Licensing, is the third minister to leave the Andrews government cabinet in just 25 hours.
Yes, a trifecta, and maybe more to come. Step forward, Anthony Byrne, Federal Labour MP, and another string of leaked text messages.
Describing former Labour Senator Sam Dastyari as a crooked, corrupt expletive, another enemy, Alan Griffin, I want his head cut off, and worse. And on Victorian Premier Daniel Andrews, he said, I hope this signs his death warrant politically.
What a bunch of expletives! We've recently bagged out some crap stories on 60 Minutes, but with this one, Nick McKenzie and his team nailed it. But now to a challenge. How to lose $500 million in 8 years. Answer, buy some iconic magazines, sack staff, axe titles, and flog them all off in a garage sale. Sounds crazy, but that's what Bauer Media has done, selling all its mags to a bunch of bankers for around $50 million. That's around $500 million up in smoke. But wait, there's more. You can also trash your brand by making stuff up, like this week's Woman's Day.
I'm gonna miss you both. You're both fired.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, I read it. I read it this morning. The morning show has been axed.
And Larry, for one, was shocked.
We've won every national ratings block since we started 13 years ago. Are they going to axe that?
I don't need to tell you, it's all bullshit. And Bauer's newly acquired No Idea is no better. With its lead this week, a mag editor's dream, Jen telling Megan to stay away from Brad. Ooh. And they tease the story with this photo of Brad and a brunette. Ooh, so who's the mystery woman? New Idea wants us to think it's Megan. But we reckon it's this fan hugging Brad back in 2011. Same ponytail, same goatee, same hat, same glasses. Yep, talk about a gosher. And speaking of being caught out, Fox News claims that Black Lives protesters in Seattle's new police-free autonomous zone are fighting among themselves and turning on their alleged leader, Raz Simone.
One posting on social media that has now been deleted read this: I didn't vote for Raz. I thought we were an autonomous collective, an anarcho-syndicalist commune at the least. We should take turns to act as a sort of executive officer for the week.
Hilarious! Those anarchists are always good for a laugh. But this time the joke was on Fox, because the blistering attack was in fact a famous rant from Monty Python's Holy Grail.
What? I told you, we're an anarcho-syndicalist commune. We take it in turns to act as a sort of executive officer for the week.
Whoops! And Sir Lancelot himself, John Cleese, called them out. Hashtag good journalism. And we'll be back with real good journalism Monday night on MediaWatch, 9:15 on the ABC. Also, I have your social media. Don't miss it.